What's going on, guys? Welcome to yet another Arduino tutorial in which we're going to be discussing a slightly advanced topic which is based on two of my tutorials. So I highly recommend you watching them before you jump into this one. So number one, it's the servo control, and number two, it's the ultrasonic sensor control. So in this tutorial, we're going to be combining the two in order to create a system which is called essentially a scanner sweep, in which we're using the positioning of the servo in order to read a particular distance to the target. So just a quick demo for you. So as soon as I push this button, the sensor is going to be rotated 180 degrees. It's going to read each value at every single degree, and it's going to report at the end the closest object that it sees, as well as the angle at which that object is appearing. So this is extremely useful in robotics. You can mount it on a robot in order to find the closest target. So for something like a sumo bot competition, you want to detect your opponent, you want to push them out, you can very accurately know what their coordinates are and then act accordingly. You can also use this to avoid obstacles. Instead of mounting several sensors, you can just mount one on the servo and then scan the area like so. So yeah, like I said, two videos that you should really watch before jumping into this one. I'm going to be posting the links above. And yeah, let's take a look at the hardware you're going to need. Let's take a look at the software, the combination of the two programs, and how this whole system works. So what you're going to need in terms of hardware is the servo. I'm using the same one that I used in the previous tutorial, so if you want to know how to control this one, you can refer back to that, or you can use any other servo. As far as I'm concerned, as long as you can get the positioning going correctly, then you shouldn't have any problems whatsoever. You're going to need an ultrasonic sensor, and once again, you can use a different sensor, you can use a photo optic, a laser sensor. As long as you can get the distance accurately, then that's also fine. So I'm using the SR04 range sensor. It's an ultrasonic sensor that I've used in one of my previous tutorials. You're going to obviously need your Arduino. And then finally, I'm using a push button, and this is just purely to minimize the action of the servo, because I had it spinning for about 15 minutes on its own, and I decided to just control it with a push button. Obviously, you can do it through the software. You can have it pulsate every minute if you wanted to. You can have it pulsate once every 10 minutes. It depends on your application. So just to let you know that the button is not necessarily part of the whole system, but I just wanted to limit the control of the control loop. So yeah, that's all you need in terms of hardware. Obviously some wires, the Arduino itself. And yeah, let's take a look what it takes in order to program this whole assembly. So like I've mentioned, the program is going to be in large a combination of the two previous programs, so the servo and the ultrasonic sensor one. So we will include the servo.h library, followed by a new servo called servo1, followed by an integer specifying the position of the servo. We're going to define the trig and the echo pins for the ultrasonic sensor, as well as the button that I'm going to be using as well. The long duration and distance are used in the ultrasonic sensor program in order to store the duration of the pulse, as well as a distance which is calculated based on the duration of that pulse. The closest target and angle target are new registers which will be storing the distance to the closest object and then the angle to the closest object. In my setup function, I have a serial.begin at 9.6k baud rate that will allow us to communicate with the computer terminal. We're going to attach the servo to pin 9, specifying the trigger to be an output and the echo and the button pins to be inputs. Followed by our loop function. So the first thing I do is I check the button. If it is high, I execute the rest of the loop. Otherwise, it just keeps on looping without executing anything. You can remove this functionality if you think for your purpose it is better to just keep cycling the servo. So just remove this if you wanted to continuously monitor the targets. This for loop is used to sweep the servo from 0 to 180 degrees. So it will increment by 1 degree every single time. It will write the position to the servo. It will take a delay of 10 milliseconds and then write. This is the logic for the ultrasonic sensor. So we will write the trigger to low, wait 2 microseconds, write it to high, wait 10 microseconds, and then write it to low. So it will send a pulse of 10 microseconds, like I've explained in the ultrasonic sensor tutorial. Based on that duration, so it will read the signal which returns back to the ultrasonic sensor. It will check the echo pin, and the distance is going to be calculated by dividing the duration by 58. So this is going to give you a distance in centimeters. If you want it in inches, please refer back to the constant in the other tutorial. Here is a check which we do if the closest target is larger than distance. So if the new found target is closer than the previous closest target, then it's going to replace that distance into closest target, and it will store the new angle target position. So what this does is, during the sweep, it will find the closest target to your ultrasonic sensor. Next, we have the return of the servo from 180 degrees back to zero. So same loop as before. And at the end of the whole routine, we have some serial print. So it will print the closest target. So what's the distance to the closest target, and what is the angle to the closest target, followed by a setting of the closest target to 1,000. So this just essentially, I know that the closest target is going to be closer than that, so I want to make sure each time it reinitializes to a large value. So if we compile the program, verify, upload, so that should load the program into the Arduino. And once you toggle it, you can see the ultrasonic sensor sweep. If we go into the serial monitor, we can see some of that data. So let's just push the button. The first sweep might be a little off, so no worries about that. Let's just do it one more time. So here is our first accurate sweep. So as you can see, the target angle, so the closest target was at 93 degrees, and the closest target was also at 22 centimeters. So a few things to be aware of is that your ultrasonic sensor is not as precise as a laser sensor, for example. So you will pick up some noise if you decide to put it on a table surface or just on the floor. So I highly recommend, if you're going the ultrasonic sensor route, to use some sort of a elevated surface to actually do your experiments. So mount it on a pole, mount it on your robot. Don't just let it stand kind of on a flat surface, because you will get a lot of noise. So just something to watch out for and be aware of, because you will have that that pulse rebound back into the sensor. So like I mentioned in the other tutorial, it's not a straight line that leaves the sensor. It's essentially like a cone that it's trying to pick up. So if you have, for example, a target at 30 degrees, it might not necessarily be the optimal angle, but you can probably see it at 50 degrees, you can see it at 45 degrees. So it has some play in its detecting capabilities, and that's just something you want to be aware of. So yeah, hopefully you guys learned something. Let me know if you're actually planning to implement something like this. It is fairly straightforward once you start playing with it. And like I said, it's quite useful. You can save yourself some sensors. You don't need to mount a bunch of detection sensors on your robot or whatever. And instead, you can use a servo. You can even use a linear servo if you want to sweep linearly. So that's another option you have. So thank you guys for watching once again. Thank you guys for subscribing. So I will be posting the code for this video and a couple of my previous videos on my website. So the link's gonna be right here on your screen. The second thing I wanted to mention is I'm finally done with the setup of the forum. So if you want to chat with like-minded people, it's pretty small right now, but hopefully it will pick up. click the link right here and leave your questions, leave your comments for me. It's going to be the easiest way of reaching me. Otherwise, once again, thank you guys for subscribing. Thank you guys for watching my videos. Thank you for all the nice comments. Keep the questions going. I haven't had that much time to answer all of them, but I will certainly do my best. And yeah, thank you once again. See you next time.